Waves has released the Create Sampler, or better said, Sample Player. Now, Waves is known for the $29 plugins, and this one will sell for $9.99, which is a steal. And the bundled Cosmos Sampler Finder is actually free. To start working with this plugin, you need to load in a sample. You can do that with drag and drop, or use the Cosmos Sample Finder. More on that later. I will use a drum loop. Create will do some analyzing and by default have your sample automatically placed all over your keyboard, and it defaults to play and the classic algorithm. When you open that algorithm tab, you'll get a few variations which all sound different with the sample you have loaded. Now, by going here, you can really easily adjust the length of the sample, and the same goes for the end of the sample. Let's enable sample looping. It's easy to find the right loop point like this. You have some playback modes like reversed, back and forth, and hold. Which sounds very granular. So far, all of this is really easy to do and to set up. I like that. Down here are some controls. An ADSR. And a very sweet filter section with four filter types. Two slopes, a useful resonance dial, and drive. This filter sounds really juicy to me. I love it. If you press here, you're opening a nice rabbit hole. There are four modulators, which all can be switched between wave or sequencer, and four ADSRs. That should be plenty to modulate your audio to make it sound more interesting. Let's use this plain bass guitar note and add some modulation. You can hear that this simple plain bass gets more interesting. It's also easy to create a synth pad with this bass note. There are some sample adjustment options I didn't mention yet. Like this, if you loop, it sounds terrible. By dragging here below, you can add fade in and fade out. this gets better. And when I readjust the start of the sample, these fades will become a crossfade and you get a pad-like sound. Now, one of the things I had way too much fun with is the ability to assign parts of a loop to specific keys on my keyboard. So here I have the first drum loop again, and when I go to the keyboard zones tab, you'll see I have this assigned to the B key. Now I have also assigned parts of the loop to the other keys. If you paid attention, you will see these tabs here light up. Now, these are samples assigned to different keys. You can do that really simple. Just drag a tab onto an empty tab like this. Assign a root note and do the same in the zones tab. Now you can trigger a part of the loop with that one key. Adjust the loop to whatever you want. This way you can build nice variations of the same loop. If you program MIDI notes, you can get something like this. Now I also found a cool synth bass preset, and together it sounds like this. I want to add more to this loop, one-shot samples, maybe vocal. And that is where the Cosmos Sample Finder comes in handy. With the Create and Cosmos comes a sample library of 3 to 4 gigabytes, which is a lot. Let me find a cool vocal. I type vocal, which gives me all vocals, and I know the bass line ends in G, so let's find something in G.
Snow.
I like this one. Let me add some modulation to this vocal. And let's add another sound. You might have noticed that every sound right now is bone dry. There aren't any effects like reverb or delay in here. You need to add this later with a separate plugin. So be very aware if that you want to do, for instance, drum kits, you probably want to use multiple instances of this sampler. To me, the Create sampler feels like it was built with ease of use in mind. Is this the most in-depth and complete samplers out there? No, it isn't. It's also not a sampler revolution or something. It is a very, very solid plugin, a tool you want to use. It does give for a user like me more than enough versatility, adjustability and options to get going very quickly. I like that a lot. Let me know what you think of the plugin in the comments below and let's avoid this. Link to the plugin is in the description, and if you want to know about a great effect to use with Create, watch the video which is displayed on screen and also linked in the description below.